Hey guys, Iggy back again. I'm here at PAX at Devolver Digital with Josef. Josef, you want to introduce yourself?
Hi, my name is Josef. I'm a developer from Scum, mainly community manager, and we're here to talk about our game.
All right, cool. Thank you very much, and pleasure to meet you.
All right, let's delve into it. So first of all, I want to clear out what Scum really is. In its core, it's a hardcore survival simulation game. One of its, the next level of it, so to say. What we introduced to it, new, actually, when people ask me, what game you would compare Scum to, there's really no answer.
Okay.
Because we took the popular games that are out there, we took everything from them, the good parts that people like, and put it in there, and added a little flavor to it that I will show later.
And so I like that because I've been interviewing a lot of people. Some people just throw the game together. This is the way I want the game to be.
Yeah.
Rather than looking at other games and seeing what's good, what's bad, and just, you know, people that care about the game, they make a better game. And I've been watching videos on this, and you guys may not be able to tell right now, but the environment, everything is not only beautiful, but it's interactive.
Yeah.
The sounds are great. But we'll get into that in a minute. Was there more you wanted to say?
No, that's pretty much it. I will explain everything as we go through it.
Okay.
All right, so the whole show will start with the character creation screen.
Okay. So I'm gonna go ahead and focus in a little bit more.
Sure. Okay, so let's go to the character. This is where everything will start. So, the story behind Scum as well. Scum, it's a TV show on an island that is made for death row inmate prisoners.
Okay.
They are put on the island and they need to survive. And as I said, it's a show, it's followed, and people in the real world watched.
Okay.
So, this is, like, we have our prisoner here, this guy, like, Family Guy. And here, as we you can see it. You can select your age. It ranges from 20 to 50. What's the difference in here? The difference is between the attribute points that you get extra depending on your age.
Right.
Attribute values. This is a nice twist that I said that a lot of survival games actually don't have. We added a bit of RPG-ish feel into Scum as well. Attribute points, we have four of them. Strength, Constitution, Dexterity, Intelligence. Strength is mainly used is considering how much you can carry, how strong you are, how well you can recoil the gun and stuff like that. Constitution is based most for stamina, how fast it develops, how fast it regenerates, how fast you can run, how much pain you can tolerate for certain medical actions to hit in. Dexterity, that's revolved around agility.
Okay.
How fast you are, how fast you can pull out your weapons, and those stuff. Intelligence is mostly about the know-how skills, medical skill, programming skill, ranging with a scope, and stuff like that.
Okay.
Then this is the typical, like the usual games have a little bit of modification. We'll have different head types.
Yeah.
Skin color, gender. We'll add also females into the game. Tattoos, because let's be prisoners.
Right.
They have tattoos. And flaws. The funny thing also that we added flaws because convicts.
Yeah.
You will be able to choose a flaw. For now, we have alcoholism, smoking, drug abuse. Myopia. I'm not sure what that is.
Which one?
Myopia.
Myopia.
Myopia. Once that will be implemented in the game, you will get bonus points to spend on your character, but there will be drawbacks. If you choose, I don't know, drug abuse.
Right.
When drawback hits in, it's not great. Or alcoholism. You need alcohol. Cigarettes. You need cigarettes.
So, and that I've never seen that in any game. Is there an advantage to a flaw?
Yes, you will get bonus points that you can spend in your skills.
Okay.
That will come right now.
Okay.
And on the beginning of the game as well, you will be able to choose some basic gear, maybe a knife, maybe a can of food. So you just have something to start with. So not butt really naked onto the island. All right. So this is the RPG-ish part of our game.
Okay.
Skills under each of the attribute window. Let's say strength skills, we have for now unarmed combat, rifles, and melee. So what we did, in the previous game as, fun fact, the character changes depending on, so, depending on what kind of character you wanted to make, the achievement points that you gotta distribute, you will have skill points for distribution. You can select anything pretty much here, whatever the player wants to, what character he wants to have.
Okay.
And all of those skills, nothing of this that you select is permanent. Okay. So this is not set in stone.
Oh, okay.
A scum is a dynamic environment. Everything you do will grant you in some way some experience points for something. Running, just by running you'll get experience for running. Resistance, cold, if you have enough vitamins in your body, and if it's a cold weather, and if you endure it and don't get a cold, resistance will grow. Throwing, you throw, you'll get experience points. So any action you do will give you experience points for something.
Okay.
So let's say we set up our character. We'll now jump into single player to slowly get you into the game.
Okay. We have left, but the loading. I was gonna read that for everybody, but I'll focus it. I'll zoom.
It's a typical early. It's early access. Don't get mad at us if something is broken.
Okay,
that's a short story. Right? All right. For now, this spawning place is made for the event that we will jump in later. I will show you. The spawning place for each character will be anywhere on the app. So this is the map for now. It's 12 by 12 kilometers, 142 square kilometers, if I'm not wrong. The nature, it's made by the Croatian vegetation and the climate.
Yep.
Mediterranean climate, as people like to say. We have like the foresty parts here, the coastal parts, the nice beaches, and the mountain part here.
Yes.
Weather will be dynamic, fully. You'll be able to sunbathe down here or go to a snowball fight up there, depending on whatever you want to explore.
Yep.
Alright, so once you spawn into the game, you will be able, I said it's gonna be later, you will be able to do anything you wanna. Here comes the kicker. When we played our survival games, and when you're dropped just on the map straight away,
right.
And yeah, you have the freedom of doing anything you wanna, but there's, I can do anything. What will I do?
Right.
You know, that's a little bit of confusion. That's why we'll probably later on small, let's say, quests, interactions that you can do. Here comes also the RPG-ish feel that I saw the skills. We had a lot of our testers in the closed beta. Yeah, I just spawned on the place and I had already had some idea what character I want to build up, and I went towards that way. So already with that system, people have can have some goal in mind, what they want to do, what they want to build.
Okay.
Now, this is the fun part of the game. The metabolism that makes scum so unique, actually.
Okay.
And the first of its kind. For us, we did a lot of research and we didn't find in any game and beyond the gaming industry such a simulation of a human body. It's real time and it's accurate. Here we have the nutrition window. So calories, protein, fat, fiber, water, sugar, saturated fat, sodium, all of the vitamins and minerals.
So what you're saying is in this game, I can make myself more healthy.
Yes, you can.
Following this.
Exactly.
All
you
right.
can do anything you want. So, this kind of tends to look really intimidating to people.
Right.
It's all normal.
At first, yeah.
Of course. But there's... It's natural. Did you consider how much B12 vitamin you took today?
Sorry, say that again?
Did you count how much B12 vitamin you took today?
Absolutely not.
Not.
But I had an amp, an energy drink, and that does have B12 B6.
And B6. B12 is pretty much in everything. Maybe I'm wrong, but I think it is. So yeah, this is for real hardcore players.
Okay.
Wanna go into it and I will make a character that's be anything really, any type, and he can continuously watch over this, what is going on, and how it will do. You also have like calorie consumption that's updated in real time. Also, of course, depending on how big your character is. Calories, all of the consumption is dynamic. if you run uphill, calories will be spent faster and more. If you run downhill, 340, we're running uphill. It's getting a bit normal. It all depends.
Okay.
That's why no character in Scum will be the same. It's literally impossible. Okay. The closest you can be is if you make the same character
with a failure.
That's the closest you can get to being the same. Because as I said, the whole world is dynamic. Let's say you and your friend come to a fist fight and he knocks your teeth out because we have a teeth number here as well.
Okay.
What happens then? You can't eat solid food anymore.
Okay.
You need
to brush your teeth?
No.
Because that's important.
That's important. That's important. And if you can't eat solid food anymore, well, you'll need to find another way.
Right.
If you don't, you will get weak. You will go down. Your calories will suffer and you will deteriorate.
Right.
Or let's say you injure your leg.
Okay.
You injure your leg. What happens then? You can run really fast. You run a bit slower. Calories are not consumed as much as they needed to be, and you get bigger.
No, actually, you brought up something. Let's say I break my leg, I break my arm. Does it heal?
Yes, of course. It can
awesome.
Heal. That will depend on the medical skill.
Okay.
We have also medical skill. Pretty much anybody can patch a basic wound up.
Right.
And that's not a problem. But some like us, we will have also diseases in the game and sicknesses and all of them. It will depend on the medical skill what you can treat.
Okay.
You know, the chip that you see.
Uh-huh.
This is the center of our prisoner. The chip allows the prisoner to have this user interface and to keep track. Because each prisoner on the island has that chip that monitors him. So he can't really do anything to watch.
The main goal of the game is actually to get away from the island.
For that to happen, you will need to remove the chip. For that, you will need somebody with a big medical skill,
okay.
Surgeon. You will need a programmer. Bypass the electronic parts, hacking parts, because if you just want to remove it now, it will go boom, and you have a little.
So you're saying you could remove the chip and there's a world outside of the island?
For now, there is no world outside of the island, but that's just the goal, to escape.
Oh, I see, okay.
In the lore, this is the second season.
Okay.
In the first season, there are rumors that some prisoners escaped the island.
Okay.
So we will probably at one point include a single player campaign into the game, that will have missions, NPCs, etc. And the whole point that will be to escape, you will need to make contact with the people that escaped from the island, they will have to navigate through it and to get away from it.
Okay.
So where did we stop? I kind of got lost myself. I didn't do that.
Well, we were talking about the health, we were talking about his teeth, breaking a bone, healing.
So all of that comes to a dynamic environment, Scum, that you can, but most of the time you won't control. Because you never know when a rain will hit, when a storm will hit. You maybe watch your wetness video.
Say it again?
Wetness video that you made.
Well, I did, so I watched the video, or I watched a few videos, and we were by the water, but I think it was going just around the environment.
All right, fair enough.
So, how will Scum handle being in the rain?
Right.
It sounds like a trivial thing, but it's big in importance.
Probably slows you down.
So, this is our inventory menu. We have a layered clothing system that you see here. So you can have a t-shirt, then you can have maybe a hoodie, jacket, raincoat, whatever you want. This is for the head part, for the upper part, this is for the torso, and this is for the legs.
Okay.
Each of the clothing system has how much water it can take or consume in itself, and that will also impact the weight of the clothes. You see here is zero. If it gets wet, it will become heavier.
Right.
For some reason. Because that's how it's done.
Right.
If you have a raincoat, it won't.
Okay, nice.
Easy as that. If you walk around in wet clothes, you can get a cold. You will get sick.
Right.
Of course, if you get it, it won't kill you if you're a bit wet. Just find a shelter, make a fireplace, put your clothes
nice
besides it. It will dry up, and you're good to go.
Yeah, I spent a lot of thought behind the game.
Yeah, this is just like the scratch. We're just building the foreground now.
Yeah.
Then we will just build it up. The most important thing is we make all those things with our community. you know, we take their advices. What do you think is good? What do you think is bad? We already removed a few things that we got feedback from our testers.
Okay.
So, in a way, we're making this game
with a player base.
As we want to make a game, because all of the survival games are kind of meh right now, to be honest. And we want to make something that will jump out and be for everybody. Because Calm has a low entry level, anybody can start to play it. And all the way to the hardcore people that you saw the nutritionists up there who will be into that and keep a track every second of it.
So cool.
So I know how much time we have. I can.
Plenty. Yeah. That's
nice.
Yeah.
Okay. We can actually today what we are showcasing here is an event. It's some kind of a
actually so that everyone can see it. So it's not just one computer here. It's actually. All these.
We have 10 PCs here.
Let me flip it around so I can see what I'm doing. All right, so you can see here, and actually, it's not just this pretty environment. We're in a jail cell. We're in a fence. Hey, what's up? Cool game. So, yep, that's where we are right now, and I'm tangled up.
So, actually what we are presenting here today is not this survival part. Because for an event like this, if you want to get the real feel for the survival, you need to play the game for 2-4 hours.
Right.
And for an event like this, we can't really do that.
Right.
So what we made is an actual event. Events will be also present in the game. This will be for the people who like more of a shooty type of a game. Let's go with that. As this is a TV show and people want some action from time to time, we will incorporate the game various events. This one is Capture the Cargo, playing simple, two teams. Each team has a key spawning at their side, a few hundred yards away. Who gets first to the key needs to get to the center where there's a cargo, keep it for 2 minutes, and they win the round.
Okay,
easy. Events will be mandatory. Is that the right word? That you won't need to go in if you don't want to go in.
Oh, they'll be optional.
Optional. Yes, exactly. Sorry.
No problem.
They're optional. Nobody will force you to go to play the events if you don't want. You can chill on the island, survive, do your own stuff. If you see an event that looks good to you, hey, I want to try it. Just join it, go in, it'll teleport you there. You play the event, you go out.
Okay.
There will be a system in Scum called Fame Points.
Okay.
Fame points will be awarded to the players for pretty much anything.
Okay.
You will be able to. This is how we're trying to deal the situation with death in survival games. Because for now, each replay, when you die, you start new without anything. Okay. And that was really frustrating for us.
Right.
That's, you know, like if you spend in something 10, 20, 50 hours, you need to start again.
You want something to show for it.
Yeah, I mean, some people like it, mostly don't, as I researched.
Right.
So what we do is, if you have enough fame points, you will be able to resurrect your character with a skill sense.
Nice.
Then you lost.
Yeah.
Maybe if you have really a lot of them, we'll be able to incorporate maybe to get back some of your gear.
Okay.
Some not. We will see if this is still in the works, but we will try not to too much to punish people.
Okay.
Okay.
Fame points will be mostly awarded for the events,
okay,
for now. So this is kind of an initiation for people to go and play if they want to survive or just plain shoot.
All right.
So let's go. It's currently going on.
Yeah, it looks like.
But I think we can drop in if something does crash.
So while this is loading, I want to show you guys real quick. So like right over here, we have people playing against each other. And it looks like that's what we're going into right now as well, right?
Yes, this is where we're going.
Oh. Alright, so here we are.
Here we go.
Let me zoom out here.
So, this is a spawn site. What we did in SCUM, that a lot of game doesn't have, that's switching between first person,
right,
third person view. So people can play however they want.
That's nice, yeah.
All right, so let's gear up. Simply gearing up here. Got an AK. We have granites here. Paper gun. So for now, it looks like our team is holding the cargo. And pretty simple. Some things that we did is also when you go in. So this is what we really was frustrating to us. Like if you're behind a wall or something, and like you need to, yeah, just want to look around, you need to do this. So what we did is that implement the system where you just go a little bit. Why?
Okay. Nice.
Because in SCUM,
depending on the pressure.
What?
Depending on the pressure.
Yeah. So okay. depending how much you want to. Because in SCUM, we solved the problem with third-person games when you're here, like, and you can see over the wall or somewhere. So if there's a player, you would see it.
Right.
Right. In SCUM, no. You don't see. You only see what your player sees.
That makes sense.
So if somebody is there now, it will be like this. What you need to do, you need to go lean, and he will then pop up and run. This is, as we saw in a lot of current Battle Royale games, people complain. I mean, they were not complaining, but it was not really to their forte.
As
people want. So this is pretty much straight up. The ballistics in the game is real time. It's G1 or G7, I'm not sure. We also have hit zones on the body, of course.
Okay.
So if you got shot in the arm,
that's nice.
Or a leg or something like that, it will insta kill. If you got shot in the head,
right,
it will insta kill.
Right.
Well, what sounds something also interesting, that we had a situation is ricochet.
Oh, nice.
We had a dead. It's a bit hard to see. See?
Yeah, that's awesome.
There it goes.
Let's say I was standing right here
and killed from the ricochet.
Yeah. That's awesome.
Also, we had some funny situations, like we were throwing grenades and Kolek, he was just with a shovel swinging and he hit the shovel just as he was swinging and it sent the grenade all the other way. So there's also with all of those mechanics.
So if I throw a grenade, can I essentially play baseball and slap it with the shovel?
Well, if you're really precise, yes.
That's awesome.
It's kind of hard.
No, I'm not saying it's easy, but the fact that you can do it.
Is it possible? Yeah. That's nice. One down. Okay, I want you to try it out now.
Sure.
So, a few things to consider. Scroll. With scroll, you change your speed.
Weapon? Oh, your speed.
You have running, jogging, and walking. You jump with V, not space. Space will be in our game, entering and exiting combat mode.
Okay. Now, can you remap the keys if you want to?
Yes, you will.
Okay, great.
That's no problem. We have climbing, stairs as well. Now, or pretty much. We have a nice also, if you go down there and find an open window, You will be able to
jump out?
See. Yes.
Oh, okay.
We have nice walking action mechanics. Oh, there's open window. And you press V.
I'm used to space.
Yeah. Everybody is.
And how do you switch
between the views? Enter.
Ah, okay.
Enter.
And
scroll is for speeding up. And
there
here
we go.
Your players have the name tag. Those are your teams.
Oh.
The enemy team doesn't have any.
That's how you see.
We tried to make it as real as possible.
Okay.
We got actually some complaints where people it will respond. Where people compare a game to Call of Duty. That's a huge thing for us. You know?
You want to be compared to Call of Duty?
Well, of course we can compete with them. But when people put a game that was made by 16 people,
right,
with a AAA, it tells you that they think they put you a little bit above, you know.
Right. How do you
press enter?
No. How do you if I wanted to look through a scope?
Just click the right button.
Oh, okay. I was holding it.
When you hold the right button, hold it.
mode? Sorry.
You see, that zoom in,
okay.
That's focus mode.
I see that.
This is connected to a skill called awareness. So when you go around and you're in a focus mode, you some certain items will be highlighted, so you can track them easier. And also what we have is the gut. We try to put the gut feeling of the player into the game. Yeah, that's an enemy.
Oh, yeah.
What it means, like if you're in a focus mode long enough and you see an enemy player and if you're on him for a certain amount of time and if you're aware the skill is good enough, if he goes behind an object, you'll for a short time see like a blurry line where he maybe went. We tried to get into the game that real gut feeling of the person being in there.
Okay.
That's awesome.
And it's pretty.
And it's beautiful.
This guy. Will he reset it?
He killed it.
There you go. Of course, we will have AIs.
Oh, nice. Well, can you select if you want to play with AI or without AI?
For now, it's in multiplayer.
And gotta stop it real quick.
So for now, we got a lot of people asking, okay, will we have maybe first person only servers or third person only servers? Can we play just alone without AI, people, single player?
Right.
We will try to make it possible that you can select all of the stuff when you're on a server, if you buy a server.
So, is there a cap to the number of people on a server?
For now, it's about 60 plus players.
Okay.
60 players per server.
So, let's say right now I come in, there's only 20 people on each side, so 40. There'll be an additional 20 on each, or 10 on each side for AI. And then if people want to join, will it kick the AI out so that people can come in?
No. You mean substitutions for people in the game?
No, like for example, if you're, you know, the server needs 60 people to play.
Oh, it doesn't need 60 people.
Oh, okay.
Sorry.
Okay, no problem.
It's like for now, we can, on a server can go about 60 people.
Okay.
It's the, you don't need to have a certain amount and then the game is up. Because Scum won't be a session-based game.
Okay.
It's not like Battle Royale. The world will be permanent.
Okay.
And somebody's gonna be dumb. So
I lost teeth.
So the world will be permanent. You can always go play, log out, come back, and the world, the server will be here without any problems. The AI, I'm not sure if you maybe saw, we have quote unquote zombies, but they're not real zombies. How we dealt that problem is when you die in a game, a prisoner died, that chip that they have in their head, he will actually takes the control of the nervous system and brings the player up.
Okay. Oh, that's pretty cool.
So that, I mean, people call them zombies, we call them puppets.
Right.
You know, you can't force people to call them something else if they associate. We will of course have animals, aquatic animals, fishing will be a thing as well.
So, now that you mentioned animals, for example, let's say there's a wolf there. Can that wolf attack you?
Yeah.
That is awesome. Yeah. But so you're not only worried about all the people, you're worried about nature.
Yes.
That's awesome.
We cut out with our videos, if you watch, if you look at them.
I did, but I didn't see that. That's pretty cool.
We tend to put a lot of bears in our videos.
That is awesome.
Yeah.
So you have to be completely aware of your surroundings.
Exactly. This is what actually, as I mentioned before, if somebody just wants to survive with the wildlife, right, go do it. You have more than enough content to enjoy the game. Wolves mostly travel in packs, you know?
Right.
Just hitting one, possible, not likely. And they're really dangerous, I don't like them at all.
Right.
Bears, yeah, stay. If you then have some nice gear that you can actually beat up somebody, this is for now, for the event, just a lobby. So people can change, come in, and the event that you played now will begin again in 1 minute, 40 seconds.
Yeah.
It won't be like this in the game. For the event, let's say the whole island will be a lobby, you know?
Okay.
So, as I said, there's an event, you join, time goes up, you pop in like you just did in the event, and that's it. compared to the AI, we will try to make it as various as possible. The puppets that we have, you know, some are more aggressive, some are not, some are faster.
But so when you were mentioning the AI, I thought it was when you spawn, there's maybe an equal amount of AI. But you're saying there is no AI until somebody dies.
No. There will be.
Oh, okay.
That'd be a bit weird, right?
But that would be kind of cool, though.
True. We actually considered like that. If you die, that player, character, will come back as a puppet.
Right.
We will see just how to do this. But most of the time, the zombies that it ties into our war to have them already around. You know, those ex-prisoners that died and they attack you. They're hostile. Also, regarding the lore, the island was before the TV show used for military experiments. There are several military secret bases underground. People, they did a lot of nasty stuff down there. I can go, and a lot of nasty, aggressive, and mad products are down there. And some of them are maybe even released on the island. We'll add it later in the game. That's not yet.
Okay.
Now. There's a lot of work to that. But yeah, there will be so much content, and everybody will be able to find something for themselves.
That's awesome.
If you just want to play and survive and take it easy, cooking skill, it's huge. In a way, you will be able to open your pizza shop really if you want.
Nice.
If you have the ingredients. We don't have base building in the game. We got a lot of questions for that.
A lot of what, I'm sorry?
Questions for base building.
Oh, okay.
So can you build bases?
Yeah.
No, but what you will be able to do is fortify current buildings.
Okay.
You know, go into a house, put barricades in it, make a lock.
Nice.
Maybe craft out a little stash that you'll put your stuff in.
Can I start a family?
Well, not
something maybe you want to add.
Well, if people really, really, really want that, we can take a look.
Right.
You know, that's a problem. We're flexible. There's also a lot planned for the future. Like, we will have probably some kind of safe zones.
Okay.
Where players will be able to come. You won't be able to kill. You will be able to spend also fame points for, let's say. It's a problem when you're focused on one goal and you hit a badass sickness, something that will kill you, you know. You know, as it is real, as we want to make the game real, it can't be like frustrating, you know. The safe zones will have a lot, maybe even you come there, you know, you have some type of sickness, you use some fame points, you heal yourself, because this is like the future, not the future, but
I fell through the world.
It happens. No worries. We plan to make it possible, maybe to drop from the sky, who knows.
Who knows?
Yeah. This is like a future about maybe 50, 100, 150 years.
Okay.
So technology is a bit more advanced. So that safe zones, you can go in there, you enter maybe a machine that heals you and you're good to go. Maybe even trade something with other people, prisoners. So Scum will be really a game for itself with a live system, with a live dynamic world, live wildlife.
Yeah.
You know, I'm kind of losing words.
I was reading up on the game, of course, prior to coming here, and so it's a new world order has started.
Ah, yes.
And as you were saying, you know, companies and whatever, they've made this TV show that all of us can watch from home, and you know, you get to watch people kill each other or whatever they're doing. It's set in Croatia, as you mentioned, and the environments, you know, we can't see a whole lot right now because we're in a real game, but the environments, they're beautiful, they're amazing. So if I shoot a wall, will there be a bullet hole or okay.
Well,
so
penetration in our game is a thing. If somebody's behind a door, you shoot through the wooden door, you will hit them.
Can you break a wall?
No, for now we don't have destructibles.
Okay.
We have like broken walls already. Those are some technical stuff with the engine.
Okay. No, that's still cool. That you can shoot through a wooden door or a wooden window pane.
Yeah, awesome. You can shoot. We are like what's the word for that? density of items like brick, concrete,
right,
wood,
right.
And depending on the bullet, is it different if it's shot from a gun or maybe from a 50 caliber
sniper?
Depending
on the caliber, right.
You know, pretty much if a bullet in a real life is possible to go to concrete, it will go in your gun. To brick, it will. If it will stop, it will stop.
Okay.
It's the same with armor vest. We have also bullet vest. So penetration is a real thing in this gun.
That's awesome.
Or maybe it will ricochet, as we saw.
Right, that can kill someone.
The ricochet is amazing.
Yeah, those are just like I said, there's a lot coming for SCUM, you know, we have big plans for it. This is just like, this is not even remotely to done what we have planned for the game and for the players.
So when do you plan on releasing it?
The release is planned for Q2.
Oh wow, this year?
Yes, yeah, so this year.
Awesome.
So a few months away. And yeah, we hope for the best. For now, the feedback from PAX is amazing. People really love it. I was a bit skeptical because in our old development videos we showed survival and you come here and there's people destroying at each other.
Right, right.
But you know, when you explain them why and how, because you can really show it here, you know, they're really like, oh my god, this is amazing.
Yeah,
we love
yeah.
it, we can't wait for it. And you know, we're all really hyped there.
Yeah, and I was looking at it the past week almost, and just seeing everything you guys are doing, and I didn't see any animals, but you're mentioning there's bears, there's wolves, and maybe other things. That's an entirely other element. It's not really in, like, maybe in like fantasy games, but like, for example, like in PUBG or something, or a few other games, there isn't wildlife. You don't have to worry about only all these guys. You have to worry about all the wolves, so you have to pay attention. And so, we haven't gotten to the options yet, but I would assume availability for like 7.1 surround sound and everything.
I'll be honest with you, I'm not really too much into sound stuff.
Oh, would you mind if I looked real quick?
I don't think, for now we have just like 4 bars for sound.
Ah, okay. You know? Yeah, I was going to, you know, preface it by saying this is a beta, maybe even alpha.
Oh no, this is for now it's still alpha.
Okay, so this
will come to early access.
Even if I did go in and it wasn't there, it's not that it won't be there, it's an alpha, so.
We game parsed, we're a small studio of 17 people. So this is a huge project for us. This is something that we said, okay guys, let's go a step further, you know, for ourselves to push the limits and to make something awesome, you know.
Yeah.
We will come to early access. This is actually a big risk. When you combine early access, survival, open world, and zombies, those are kind of, somebody called them on Steam, four riders of the apocalypse. And I totally agree. And all of the fears that people have, they are legitimate and validated, you know? Because there was a lot of early access games that made money and just dropped.
Yeah.
We are really trying. We won't do that. We are here for our community. We listen to our community, we talk. If you join any of our channels, Discord, Facebook, Twitter, anything, we are talking to people. We're here, we're present.
That's awesome.
And we are all just, well, when we see things like this happening, people enjoying it, just pushing us far, you know, to make the best game possible.
That's awesome. I'm super excited. So I'm assuming this is going to be available maybe on Steam?
Yes. Okay. For now, it's going to be on Steam, early access, Q2, a few months away. And yeah.
Also, there will be early access available to the public.
Yes.
That's awesome.
Yes.
Okay.
It's like it's a release of a game, you know, just an early access system.
Sorry guys, that I have to keep looking. I can only record for about 15 minutes, so it's not that I'm paranoid, it's just I want to make sure that you guys hear everything and see everything. But we were saying about the early access on Steam. That's awesome, and I'm super excited. I'm sure a bunch of you guys are as well. So again, I don't know if there's anything else maybe that you might want to go over.
The problem is, but
we have gone over a ton.
Yeah,
no worries. Yeah. So, you know, I've already spoken to Yosef, and you know, it's not set in stone right now, but I'm hoping to be able to get this game so that, you know, for me and for the guys on Dragon Blogger, and this bites for you.
you to be able to play the game and stream it for you guys so that, you know, you guys get interested in this and, you know, help out these guys as well, because they want to bring you an awesome game, and you're not going to know if the game's awesome if you don't see it. So,
fair enough.
Yep. So, you know, with you guys, hopefully we'll be able to play the game, stream the game, show it to everybody, and, you know, just the little bit I've seen here, the little bit I've seen from home and from the hotel, everything is amazing on this game.
Yes.
So I'm super excited about it. You're one of the developers as
yes.
well? Awesome work. That's another cool thing about coming to PAX. You get to meet all the developers, not just through email, but or
yeah,
phone.
In real life.
Yeah.
For those who didn't meet us, you can jump on our community, Discord, Facebook, anything. Drop our tag. I will probably talking to you. We're open. I love to talk really much.
Nice.
Yeah. Probably you noticed that, right? So if you have any questions about Scuff, just drop in and we'll answer it.
Awesome. Well, I will say this has been the most in-depth and detailed interview I've done so far.
Really?
It is.
I still can't. Well, I like to self, but I still have a lot to learn of doing interviews. I just started doing stuff like this.
You did a great job.
Thank you. I appreciate
so,
it.
So, guys, again, you'll see more from, you know, me and Scum. And I actually, just in case you haven't seen it, Scum, you can see that right over here. That's the name of the game. The studio is Devolver Digital.
Devolver is our publisher.
Oh, the publisher, I'm sorry.
Game Fires.
Game Pires.
Yes.
Okay, I'm sorry.
No worries.
So that's awesome. But anyway, you'll see more from us soon.
Iggy, thanks for sticking with us.
Yep.
And
Iggy,
thank you for coming here.
No problem. No. Thank you so much. Iggy and Joseph with Dragon Blogger Up. See you guys.
Disclaimer: this product was provided to the author to do a review. All opinions are 100% authors and authors alone. For more information, visit bit.ly/dbdisclose. To have your product or brand showcased on Dragon Blogger, visit bit.ly/reviewmyproduct. Thank you for watching.